Hi, boys and girls. I went to the doctor yesterday afternoon because I wasn't feeling well at school, and they said that I have the flu. So I am in the bed today and will be out on for today. Hopefully, I will be back on Monday. So this purpose of this video is to just give you instructions about today as to what you're going to be doing while I'm away. A funny story, the substitute, if the substitute that picked up the job is actually the one that's there today, her name is Miss Westbury. So there's a story behind how I know her. She was my 7th grade science teacher when I was about your age at Belton Middle School. So it's been great after all these years seeing her at Southwood. Sometimes she'll sub at our school, so I've seen her in the hallway, and it's kind of funny that she used to be my teacher and now she is subbing for the kids that I teach. So that's kind of neat. Please make sure that you are on your very best behavior for her today. She was an excellent science teacher, and I want you to show her what a wonderful group of students that you are. A lot of kids will be out today on the field trip, so just know that you will be missing several people in your classroom. All of your assignments for today are in Google Classroom, but I am going to go through them so you won't have any questions about what to do. So if you'll look on the screen, I have a picture of a Google Classroom assignment, and you're going to follow all these directions in order as they appear. So right now, you are watching the video explaining my instructions for today. Then, after you watch the video, you're immediately going to go to your Google Classroom and you're going to complete your next countdown to SC Ready warm-up, number 23, and that will be on a Google form. You may use your calculator for that. And again, remember, you are earning points for extra hundreds in the grade book. Also, your Google form for today is a review of percents, and I have put some hints in the Google form for you. So make sure you read carefully and do your very best on that. After you finish your warm-up, you're going to need your earbuds to watch an Ed puzzle. Now, it's kind of a childish Ed puzzle. It's a cartoon, and it is kind of funny. But it is a good review of adding and subtracting fractions, which is what you should have learned from 5th grade. Next week, next Friday in class, you're going to take a basic math proficiency test that will help determine what classes you are in for next year. So one of the skills that will be on that proficiency test is adding and subtracting fractions. So this Ed puzzle that you're going to complete is a basic review of that. You will need a sheet of notebook paper during your Ed puzzle to do some work on, but you will not need to turn that notebook paper in. It is just for you to use during your Ed puzzle while you are reviewing how to add and subtract fractions. Next week, we will concentrate more on reviewing adding and subtracting fractions from 5th grade before you take that proficiency test next Friday. After you complete the Ed puzzle, you are going to see a PDF file that is a mixed review worksheet, and it just has a lot of questions of things that we've covered this year. Now, it is a pretty lengthy file, but you are not going to do all of these. You are only going to complete from that worksheet that you will see, you're only going to do numbers 15 through 27. So listen carefully. You're going to need a blank sheet of notebook paper. Write your name neatly at the top. Then, when you complete numbers 15 through 27, you need to show your work very neatly and write your final answer for each problem. So you're going to begin numbering your paper with number 15. Make sure you write 15, circle it, show your work for 15, write your final answer, and then put a box around your final answer. Then, very neatly, number your next problem, number 16, and do the same thing. So when you turn your notebook paper in, you should have numbers 15 through 27. Work for each one of those and your final answer with a box around it. Now, this is a review of material that we've covered. Some of this, it's been a while since we've seen this, so you may need to go back and look at your interactive notebook if you need help. Just do the very best you can on this. I would expect that you would know most of them. There was only one or two that I think you may have trouble with, but I still want you to have an answer for every single one of these. When you finish, you're going to take your paper that is neat, numbered, labeled with your name on it, and you're going to turn it into the work drop area in the appropriate drawer. Then, if you finish all of that early, I'm going to put an online link, the very last thing in your Google Classroom, and it will just be a fun link for like a word search or some other type of math assignment. So look for that as being your last link. Oh, also, I forgot to remind you, your Ed puzzle is going to have to be in a separate assignment window, so you will not see it below with all of your other assignments. So make sure that you are still completing these assignments in order as they appear. If you were to finish everything early, which I don't think that you will, then you can go to IXL and look up sixth grade adding and subtracting fractions or mixed numbers, and you can work on those IXLs. But I don't think you will have time. Also, one other thing that I want to remind you is you may not listen to music during class today. The only time you're going to need your earbuds is, of course, when you're watching this video and during the Ed puzzle. Other than that, you should take out your earbuds and make sure you are not listening to music. Okay, I think I explained everything in detail. I also left these same details in Miss Westbury's plans for today. Again, please treat her with kindness and respect, because she's a very special lady to me. She was one of my former teachers, and maybe some of you, some days when you become a teacher, maybe I can sub for your classes, which will be kind of neat. You do not have any homework over the weekend. I hope you have a great weekend. And again, I'm hoping to be back on Monday. They said I can't come back until I'm fever-free for 24 hours. So hopefully that will be on Monday. Have a great day, and thank you for your understanding and all of your hard work.